In order for Canada to meet our goals to fight climate change, the government needs to make sure that the things our industries are building today will fit with a zero emissions future. Right now, there is no way of ensuring that the decisions that go into building a large-scale, long-lasting project, such as a highway, a mine, a factory, or a pipeline, fit within Canada's climate change goals, or if it will make economic sense in a world that is increasing its efforts to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. But there's a solution, a climate change test. If every new major project is required to take a climate change test, we can make sure we're only moving forward with projects that help us reach our future climate goals. The test asks two questions. One, does the project fit in with Canada's goals to reduce greenhouse gas emissions? And two, will the project be economically successful in a future world with far fewer greenhouse gas emissions? For question one, think of Canada having a carbon budget that restricts the amount of greenhouse gases it can produce each year. To reach our climate change goals, we have to reduce that budget each year. That means that if we go over budget now, we have to make more drastic cuts in the future. Now, let's say someone wants to build a mine that will emit 10 megatons of greenhouse gases a year. While that amount might fit in a budget of 600 megatons, it probably wouldn't fit in with a much smaller carbon budget 10 years from now. So, this project won't pass the first question of the climate change test and shouldn't be built. However, if this mine can show a solid plan to reduce its projected emissions year by year that fits within our national shrinking carbon budget, then it would pass that first question of the climate change test and move forward. Right now, the federal government has emissions reduction targets in place, including a goal to reach zero emissions by 2050. But Canada doesn't yet have regional or sector-by-sector carbon budgets. These budgets should be part of the first question of the climate test. For the second question, we have to look at how projects with already high greenhouse gas emissions would fare economically in a future world where there is more action to fight climate change. As the world moves to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, it's going to become more expensive to pollute. Take, for example, a new pipeline delivering oil from the oil sands. Pipelines are very expensive to build and are designed to transport large quantities of oil. But as demand for oil continues to drop in the future, there wouldn't be enough oil to fill the pipeline. Such an expensive pipeline won't make sense economically in the future, so it would fail the second question of the test and shouldn't be built. Without a climate change test like this, it's harder to gauge which projects built today are compatible with our more environmentally friendly future. There are lots of big projects on the table that might look good now, but if built, could make it nearly impossible to meet our climate change goals. And if we don't reach those goals, Canada will be left behind to struggle in a future world where most other countries are successfully reducing their greenhouse gas emissions. You can help make the climate test a reality for Canada. Join us and call on the government to implement a test. Take action today at climatechangetest.ca.